Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make the carpet shampoo, okay? It's a formulation that I'm going to give up on the carpet shampoo, the shampoo that helps you clean your carpet, okay? If it's your first time here, make sure that you subscribe. Smash that like button, also leave us a comment. You know how much we value our subscribers here. We take time to go through each and every comment and we always make sure that we reply, okay? That's it. So what is it that I'm going to show you in this video? As I said in the beginning, I'm going to show you how to make the carpet shampoo, okay? It's a formulation that I'm going to give out, okay? We're first going to state ingredients, then after stating ingredients, I'm going to show you the sequence and ratios of mixing of ingredients, okay? Here we go, let's start by stating ingredients. So we say ingredients. You need to know that the ingredients of a carpet shampoo are, we do have water, okay, we do have sless, we do have isopropyl alcohol or ethanol. It's a matter of preference, use one of the two alcohol, and there is a brief description on this of which I'm going to explain. You do have CDE, you do have dye and perfume, okay, we're going to write this down. So you do have your water, okay, we do have sless. The sless that we're using here must have a strength of 25%, okay? We do have isopropyl alcohol or ethanol, okay? We do have CDE, we do have your dye and perfume. That's it, okay? And you need to know that when it comes to the alcohol, as we just said, it's a matter of preference, okay? You can either use isopropyl alcohol or ethanol, okay? You use one of the two. And these are two alcohol with very similar properties, okay? The thing is, isopropyl alcohol is twice as toxic as ethanol, okay? So as I said, it's a matter of preference. You'll be using the alcohol that you are much more comfortable with, okay? That's it. Now, before we can get into the sequence and ratios of mixing of ingredients, there's something very particular that I'd like to explain about this product, okay? What is it that we're going to explain? You need to know that at the end, after manufacturing this product, you obtain a very concentrated product, okay, of which you need to dilute before using. Okay, why do you need to dilute? Because it's concentrated, okay? If you use it as concentrated as it is, you'll be the one losing, okay? So you need to make sure that you actually dilute it. And what is the ratio on dilution? The ratio on dilution is of 1 to 25, okay? It means what? It means that for every 1 liter of this carpet shampoo, before using it, you need to mix it to another 25 liters of water, okay? Then you can use. And remember that we do have different types of carpet, okay? There's something I like to explain. We also have a ratio of 1 to 30, okay? This is for very soiled carpet, okay? Let's say for very soiled carpet. What do we mean? If you're dealing with a soiled carpet, okay, while using this product, you need to dilute your carpet shampoo to a ratio of 1 to 30, okay? Means what? For every 1 liter of this carpet shampoo, if you're dealing with a very soiled carpet, you need to mix it to another 30 liters of water before you can actually use it, okay? These are very important information, and if you have intention to sell this or to trade this product, these are informations that you can even put on the sticker of the product, okay, as guidance for your customers, okay? That's it. Now we can get into the sequence and ratios of mixing ingredients, okay? That's it, sequence and ratios of mixing. Okay, let's say this is by volume, okay, out of 100%. let's figure out a case whereby we're making 100 liters of carpet shampoo, okay? Let's say making 100 liters of carpet shampoo. Okay, when it comes to sequence and ratios of mixing of ingredients, this is a very critical part on a formulation, okay, of which you need to carefully pay attention, okay? Even yourself, when you be manufacturing, you need to mind about this, because if you mix ingredients in a different sequence, you may definitely obtain something else, okay? That's it. So the first ingredient to consider here, it's our water, okay? Water should be 67% of the total volume, okay? That's it. How much is 67% of 100 liters? It's 67 liters, okay? So we consider 67 liters of water. That's it. Then we do have our slurry. Slurry should be 28% of the total volume, okay? How much is 28% of 100? It's 28, so we consider about 28 kg of slurry, okay? That's it. And when it comes to the alcohol, as we say, you make a choice. Either you use isopropyl alcohol or ethanol, okay? So we say isopropyl alcohol or ethanol. It's a matter of a choice here. This should be 3% of the total volume, okay? And that is 3% of 100 liters is actually 3 liters, okay? That's it. And you also have your CVE. CVE should be 2% of the total volume, okay? How much is 2% of 100 liters? Is actually 2 liters. Okay? By doing this, you actually obtain your 100 liters of carpet shampoo, okay? 100 liters of carpet shampoo. Okay, that's it. And then there's something I like to explain on the dye and the perfume, okay? Remember that the dye, you put it according to your preference, okay? In terms of amount, okay? And the perfume should be 1% of the total volume, okay? Dye and perfume, they are important, but remember that they are considered as fillers, okay? We're stating the main ingredients. As I said, you put dye according to the appearance that you want to give to your product, that's it. And you, the amount of perfume should be 1% of the total volume, okay? Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, okay? If there's a product you're struggling to manufacture related to what we're doing, kindly communicate with us, okay? We'll make sure that we make a video on that just for you. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and see you on the next video.